Let's start with something simple. Let's say I don't like having to call an integer an int. Can we change that? Of course. We have the type alias statement, and it always follows the same template. It's type alias new name equal old name. So it would be type alias new name integer old name int. From now on, I can use integer instead of int whenever I feel like. It's all the same to the compiler. Let's see an example. These two lines that we have here are exactly the same. Integer has become an alias for int, and we can use it anytime we want. This truly becomes useful when dealing with funky types such as those of functions and closures. As an example of an odd type would be a function or closure that takes an int and returns an int. The type for this function would be this, int arrow int. That can be confusing. I don't like it. So let's give it another name, and I'll call it int to int. Now this is much better. Now instead of having to use this funky type, I can use simply int to int. That makes our life much easier. Now let's create a type alias for a function that takes no parameters, void, and returns an int. And I'll call it int maker because it makes an int out of thin air. Now we can use any of these types to define a function that takes an integer and returns an integer, or one that takes nothing and returns an integer. This will become very, very useful in the next lesson, where we finally tackle variable capture. See you there.